So now with that heavy math, I'll just interleave with this with something very simple, which is something known as dataset augmentation. So what does dataset augmentation mean? So you're always given some training data. So in the case of MNIST, you had this training data where you were given these digits, images of digits, and you wanted to train some classifier. So in dataset augmentation, what we do is, so now you have, what is happening here, right? Conceptually is that you're seeing some training data, and you're trying to build a classifier, and what you're doing actually is minimizing the empirical train error. That means it will ensure that whatever you have seen in training is going to be perfectly classified. Whatever we have seen in training, that is going to look very good. It's going to be, the error on those training examples is going to be very zero. Now my question is this: if at training time you're seeing all these twos which are roughly vertically drawn, and at test time you see a 2 which is written like this, which is slightly tilted, what would happen? It will not be able to do a good job on that. That means your model is not, think of terms that we have used in this lecture, not generalizing. Okay? Can you think of a simple trick based on your domain knowledge of how people write digits to kind of overcome this problem? You get the question? Right? I'm telling you that it's possible that someone writes a 2 in a very tilted manner. Can you prepare for that eventuality? The title of this module was dataset augmentation. So what would happen is you're given some training data. You can always generate more training data from them. So here's another training instance that I've created. I've just rotated the 2 by some random angle. I took this image, I just rotated it. And this is a simple operation, right? All the pixels I'm moving by a certain angle. I could have rotated it by more, I could have shifted it vertically. That means in all my image, the 2 was actually exactly at the center. I've just shifted it a bit vertically. So think that you are reading one of those KYC forms or bank forms. Most people would write at the center of the block provided, but some people could write to the extreme right or extreme left, right? So you're preparing for that. You're saying that, okay, all my data, the digits are well written at the center, but let me just shift them a bit so that I can also deal with people who write it at the corner. Okay, left align or right align instead of center align. I could even shift it horizontally. Most people would write it at the center, but some people would write it at the top or at the bottom. I could blur the image because someone has taken a photo and sent it to me and the photo is not very clear. Or I could just change some pixels randomly, right? I could add noise. All of this is dataset augmentation with the hope that I'm capturing, with these variations, I'm capturing enough variations in the data so that I have a better chance of doing something better on the test data. Is that fine? This is all still training data, mind you. I am still going to compute the empirical train error. It's just that now I have blown up my data by much more than what I had initially. Do you all see by doing this, you could have done better on the MNIST assignment? You could have done better? Again, I'm not asking you to do this, okay? So now I'll do this and I'll have supervised data because I know that by these small variations, the label is not going to change. And what am I using there? I'm using my domain knowledge, right? I cannot do this always, right? I hope you appreciate that. Suppose let's change the domain a bit and I'm given images of defects of motor parts, right? But I've taken an image and there's a black spot somewhere which indicates a defect. I cannot go about doing the same thing there. I cannot randomly change some other pixels. It will just mean that the defect is at a different location, right? But in many cases, you can do that. So if you are given pictures of dogs and cats because the entire world cares about classifying cats and dogs, then you could do some rotations, you could blur them a bit, you could occlude certain positions of the picture and so on, and still generate more training data, right? And what you're trying to do is trying to take care of cases that you would end up dealing at test time, right? Is that clear? Okay. And please be aware that we are exploiting some domain knowledge here. Typically, more data is equal to better learning. Works well for image classification, object recognition. So these are the tasks where this has already been tried out and has shown to work very well in these tasks. Also shown to work well for speech, where the people have some speech training data, they try to augment it. For some tasks, it may not be very easy to generate such data, right? So you could think of various NLP applications where I've given you a document, right? You could always do what Joey does in that Friends episode. Do you remember what I'm talking? Do you see what I'm talking about? So he wants to write a recommendation letter for Monica and Chandler, okay? And he has a letter written and he replaces every word by its best synonym from the thesaurus, right? So that's his way of generating noisy data, and in that case it was actually noisy, right? So you could think of doing that, but as happened in that case, it will not result in very good transformation, right? For example, I remember something like they are very warm-hearted people got translated as they have some warm cardiography or something like that, right? Which does not make sense. So it's not very easy in almost all applications to do it, but in some applications, typically in vision applications, this is easy to do, and you would gain a lot by doing this, right?